Hey everyone, how are you guys doing tonight? Y'all come on in. I want to talk about Love and Marriage Huntsville, this latest scene that was that we saw on Saturday. You guys, yeah, let's talk about it. You guys, this episode starts off with the last part of last week's episode where Mel was actually handing out the bottles to invite all the ladies who were there at Kenny and Maurice's tasting, an invitation to St. Thomas. The ladies were excited. Y'all remember Letitia was like, can she bring a plus one? Mel was like, sure, whatever, blah, blah, blah. You don't mind sharing a bed. Okay, y'all know all about that because I said it in my last video. Moving on. Now here we are. We're at St. Thomas. Y'all, it's beautiful. The resort is, it looked beautiful. Mel arrives with her two single girlfriends, with the Sharnita Foster and Lauren. Lauren, her makeup artist, and Sharnita is her one of her other good close girlfriends, right? So they're there. We see them walking into where they're going to be staying. Y'all, it looked beautiful. It looked relaxing. It looked peaceful. It looked fun, right? So they get in there. The ladies are excited. They're the first ones to arrive. Or whatever, they decided to go ahead and pick their bedrooms or whatever. After they get their rooms, these ladies get their rooms. Mel says that she didn't want to pull straws or anything. She kind of wanted to go ahead and assign rooms for the ladies who were en route to get there, right? Okay, so she informs her girlfriends that the reason why she wants to put Letitia Kimmy in the same room is because they're sister-in-laws. And because Letitia wanted to bring a plus one, they get the room that sleeps three people. Now, you guys, the room was still nice. It was nothing wrong with the room other than they were going to be sharing. It was going to be three people sharing the room. Okay. All right. I think that was fair, in my opinion. Then she puts Sunny. Sunny is in a room all to herself. She explains to her friends that because most of the women here are not fit, you know, seeing it for Sunny, she wanted Sunny to have her own room and to feel safe and secure in her own boudoir, right? Okay, so she puts Stormy and Latricia in the same room, and she gives Linnell her own room because Linnell is older. She has a lot of respect and admiration for Linnell, so she definitely wasn't going to pair her with anyone. But the only thing with that, she explained to Linnell because she didn't have a name card on the bed, and Linnell found fault with that. Now, everybody else had a name card or whatever. Linnell found fault. She found an issue with not having a name card on her bed. Okay. So you guys, they get there. They're walking around this beautiful place to find where they're going to be staying, right? Okay, so Linnell, I think she finally realizes, okay, I think they told her this is her room. Mel told her this is her room or whatever. She gets upset because there's no name card on her bed, and she makes a big deal about it. Like, she made a really big deal because her name was not on the bed. And I guess I understand she might have felt left out in that small aspect of the situation. But y'all, I'm gonna be completely honest with y'all. I don't know if Mel was drunk or had something to drink, I just don't understand her making that big of a scene. It just didn't make sense to me, but we gonna move on. So Mel has to coddle her and explain to her, Mel, I love you. I love you in real life. I would never do anything to make you feel ostracized in any way. She said the people just did not print out your name card. That is the only reason. She said, I did not forget about you intentionally or on purpose. They just didn't do it. But I made sure you had a good room by yourself and can we squash it? And it got to the point where Shanita was like, you know what? I really want you to have a good time. Shanita, being Mel's good friend, understood how good of a friend Mel is. And when Mel was explaining this to Miss Linnell, Shanita showed her it ain't that big of a damn deal. You know, she didn't say this, but she was like, I understand she loves you and I want you to feel comfortable because she wants you to feel comfortable. We can switch rooms. Them type of friends I want around me. I'm gonna be honest with you. I think we all need a Shanita. And I'm gonna get deeper into that. So then we see Kimmy and Letitia looking at their room and they are completely disgusted. They're devastated and they're hurt. And they go out, I guess, on the balcony or outside of this beautiful place. Right? I forget who it was who came to Melody to tell her. I want to say it might have been Latricia, but I'm not sure, you guys. But someone came to Melody to let her know that the ladies were not happy. So Mel goes out there to talk to these bitches. Yeah, I said bitches. Kimmy and Latricia. Not Latricia, Letitia. So Mel's like, what's the problem? Kimmy says that the rooms are really small and there's not a lot of space for them or whatever. They didn't expect to have to share a room. Letitia, she takes it a step further and she says, those rooms, the room that you picked out for us, shows me exactly what you think of us. And I don't know what Mel was feeling at that time, but me personally, you guys, I was like, and good. Good, good. If that makes you know exactly what I think about you, good. Because I don't think nothing about you guys. Mel is just trying to be the most gracious host as she possibly can. Letitia, you shot yourself in the foot. When you asked, soon as you got the invitation, whether or not you could bring a plus one, because you heard Mel say she was inviting some of her girlfriends, so you wanted to counter that. What she said and said, well, can I bring a plus one? You shot yourself in the foot, honey. She already told you your ass is going to have to sleep with somebody in your own bed. But when you get there, she showed you had your own separate bed for yourself and for your plus one. And your sister-in-law, she got her own bed. Case closed. End of discussion. This is not your trip. Just be happy you're here. And you guys, this is what I said and this is how I feel. Kimmy and Letitia, y'all better be happy Melanie put y'all asses in the basement. Because if it was me, I probably would have put y'all in the, y'all would have been lodging in the basement. Because my showing you exactly what I think about you would be up front and in your face. And if y'all were so unhappy with the accommodations, Letitia, these are your words. We're all millionaires up here. That's what you told Stormy on, I don't know if it was the last reunion, but that's what you said, honey. If it was that deep for you and Kimmy, it would have been nothing for y'all to get on Google and be like resorts near me and find you someplace that you felt better being at. I'm just saying, but y'all are the most two low-hanging fruit, low-brow ass women. I've been saying, each one of you, Kimmy and Letitia, y'all, when y'all throw an event, it is very, very basic and boring. Kimmy, that little tasting that you had, I promise you with everything on my mind, I don't care. That table that y'all was squinched up as, 12 people or 15 or 20 damn people who were there. I don't know exactly how many of y'all was there, and I'm not going to take the time out to count. But that little table, that little fold-out table, that I'm pretty sure it was, that was just only dressed up with a tablecloth and some whatever, some little decorations on it or whatever. Girl, bye. Bye. Y'all spend the bare minimum on anything that you guys plan. And then I hear Destiny on that little pathetic, pitiful ass podcast she got with her therapist. I don't think that chick is a therapist, y'all. That's a whole nother conversation for another day. This is just the most boringest thing that y'all could put on YouTube. And the only reason why I saw it, because I was on somebody else's page who played a clip on it. Because I promise you, I will not go over there just to see Destiny over there not opening her mouth, saying nothing about nothing. And just to hear her therapist windmilling for her. Destiny said it was a cash trip. And I was like, well, duh. Because all the people who were there, most of the people who were there were from the cast. And I think Destiny tried to insinuate that it was paid for by the company, by Carlos King. Y'all, I beg to differ. I really do. I really don't think Carlos King is actually going to pay for all of them to go to St. Thomas. I think that he would pay for his production crew to go to St. Thomas just so they can film. This was, in my opinion, this was Melody's trip. She made it clear when she said, y'all been on vacation, but y'all never been on vacation, the Melody shall regret. Wait. Right? She said that. That let me know Mel paid for the resort, the place that they stayed. She paid for the entertainment. She paid for all of that. If the production company did anything, they paid for production to be there to film. That's it. That's all. And just because production is there does not mean they paid for this entire trip. Let's use common sense. We ain't talking about Bravo. We talking about OWN, and we definitely talking about Carlos King. Y'all keep things in perspective now. Keep things in perspective, because we already know Carlos King don't pay nobody. That's why his cast members are working all year long. They might take a few weeks off here and there, but they back on the clock. They back on the clock. Why? Because he does it this way, so they can't negotiate their contract and ask for more pay. So that's why you have seasons A, B, and C, or 1, 2, and 3. Because he ain't paying them nothing. And he found a loophole that we all know about, or the people who are wise enough to understand, that's the loophole. He does that so he does not have to pay them or give them an increase in their pay. Right? So this show ain't making none of them rich. It might be helping them a little bit, but it's not making them rich. Anyway, back to whatever. So Mel explains to Kimmy and Letitia, the reason why they have the room that they have or whatever. They still ain't understanding whatever. Then we see Miss Linnell. She comes out there because Sunny is like, somebody might need to go out there. And Sunny, she's probably feeling like, let me send someone out here, because Mel is out there by herself, is what she was probably thinking. And she wanted Mel to have backup. Well, why in the hell did Linnell feel like she was the one to give Mel backup? I don't know, because she just had a grievance herself. She made a big deal out of nothing. She told Mel, when her and Mel was discussing the accommodations, how she did everything she could to make sure Mel was happy and safe or whatever. And I think Mel did the same thing, but only thing I can hear Linnell say is that she didn't have a name card. But anyway, Linnell takes her little ass on out there, and she's trying to squash the situation, and she's telling Letitia and Kimmy to suck it up. Why she say that? Because Kimmy was like, hold up, suck it up. She's like, I don't need no grown-up telling me, another grown-up telling me to suck it up. I think Kimmy has misplaced anger. Now, I will agree, Miss Nell didn't have to come out there and say much. She could have just been out there backing Melody up by agreeing with whatever Mel said or whatever. But Nell came out there and made shit worse, in my opinion. Kimmy got so mad, you know, they were going back and forth. Kimmy got so mad, she went off to herself and she leaned over the balcony or whatever, because she was mad, honey. And she was like, this is why I don't do girls trip. This is why I don't be around a whole lot of women. Kimmy, we know. We know you men will. You be men will. We know that. We know you feel more comfortable in a setting with a bunch of men. We know that, Kimmy. That's fine, Kimmy. Oh, my God. Girl, please get some men around here so Kimmy can feel at home. Get some men around here so they can feel at home, honey, because Kimmy is just not feeling it with all this estrogen around her. I don't know what her problem is. I don't know if she can't shimmy her way into the room showing off her boobies or whatever, because that's what Kimmy liked to do, you guys. Let's not forget, anytime they had meetings or whatever, Kimmy would come in shimmying y'all know what I'm trying to say, but she come in there shaking her top half. Let's be clear, she wanted that to be on front and center. Girl, we caught that. So finally, Leticia, she's saying basically that she's not going to ruin the trip. Yeah, girl, you better not ruin this trip and get all in your feelings and take your ass back to Huntsville just so you can be cooped up in that damn house with your kids and your husband, who be letting your ass have it every single time he can get, because he will call your ass out. You need to be called out. You need someone to call you out or whatever. So, you guys, finally, Mel brings in some entertainment. I forget what it's called over there, but she brought some women in there. They looked beautiful in their vibrant colors. They were dancing, and I think that kind of loosened everybody up for the time being. Now we're going to go ahead and we're going to get to the dinner. Now they're sitting at the table and they're having dinner. Sharnita asks Leticia if Leticia could sit at a table with people she doesn't like. And Leticia's like, yeah, absolutely. Because I'm an adult. I can handle that or whatever. Sharnita looks at Mel and she says, watch him. And she goes back and she asks Leticia more questions. And Leticia, we see her in her confessional, and Leticia's like, Mel must have talked about us prior to us meeting Sharnita, because for her to be so opinionated about us and not know us, you know, that's letting her know or let her feel that Mel has been telling Sharnita about them. Absolutely, Leticia. Yeah, you damn right. These are her best good single girlfriends. These are people she trusts. These are people that she actually deals with on a regular basis. These are people where they can have meeting of the minds together, outside of you people, outside of her castmates. So you bet your bottom dollar she's going to be talking to her friends and her close family, her close friends and her family, about you people. And, you know, you had people saying Mel brought a bully to the vacation or whatever. Mel, I'm so happy you did, girl. I think this is one of the best things. I was so happy to see it. I was there for it. You absolutely right. Why would Mel spend this money on this vacation with people she knows that does not like her? And for what it's worth, she don't like y'all either. She's okay with that. But see, she can play nice with you mofos. Melanie can play nice. And I think she played extremely nice with you people. And you damn right give Sunny her own room. Lump them three old ass coals, Kimmy, Leticia, and Destiny, in a room together, because all y'all do is talk behind her back anyway. And I feel like Destiny, she pops her ass up over there just so she can go back and tell Martell whatever she wants to tell her or whatever. Y'all, I think, I think this was a very good episode. I love that this is being, in my opinion, I think this is an authentic episode right here. I think that people said what they need to say. I think everybody showed them true selves for the most part. And next week, Destiny, she's going to be here or whatever, and I will definitely be talking about that. But I'm not over it yet. So Mel explains to Sharnita in front of the ladies that Sunny used to produce Destiny, and then Destiny was dating someone that Sunny is now married to. And Sharnita, y'all need to be mad at him. Yeah. Y'all need to be mad at the man. And then we hear Leticia, Stormy. I want to say Stormy. Y'all keep in mind, Kimmy ain't say nothing. I ain't hear nothing Kimmy say yet. even Latricia with this dust mop on the top of her goddamn head. What was that? How you go from looking real cute last episode to coming in here looking like you decided to get you a dry ass jewelry for the girl by? Let me get my thoughts. But yeah, they were saying, no, Destiny said they were friends. She was calling Destiny even after the show aired. And I'm going to be honest with you guys. At one point, I didn't see it for Sunny. I did not see it for Sunny. I think the way she came out talking and dissing Destiny, I thought that was kind of like in poor taste. But just like this show switches up, so is my opinion. My opinion, I can change my own opinion. I'm happy Mel invited Sunny, because Letitia, we all knew she was going to try to do something dirty. And she did. She invited Destiny, knowing Destiny and Mel ain't friends. Like, as a girl code, which is non-existing here, Letitia always goes out her way to show. And Kimmy is always along for the ride, because we already know Kimmy don't have no loyalty to none of these women. And if y'all don't believe me, y'all go back and watch some of the past episodes. Kimmy is none of these bitches' friends. She tolerates Tisha only because she's married into that family. Other than that, she don't like Letitia either. So then, I think this is next episode that's coming up next week. I think Melody brings out the fact that Stormy and Latricia don't like Sunny either. And, you know, we wonder why Latricia don't like her. She's like, no, I never said I don't like her. I just don't want to get too close to her or whatever. Latricia, if you don't come in here really with a valid reason or whatever, just because you Stormy friend and you work Destiny out or whatever, girl, I already can tell I'm not going to like you. I'm not going to like you. I don't really like you now, because I'm still wondering why the hell you on this show, you and Ken. I mean, I understand y'all got to bring new people in, but God dang, come on. Get some people with some substance. Get some people. Oh, my God. Y'all, this show is good, and it's exhausting, too. I know the ratings have, this has been a season low for the show. I think they were under 200,000. I'm pretty sure that has everything to do with the blackout or whatever. And people are kind of tired of it, you guys. But I'm going to keep reviewing it. Y'all, tell me y'all thoughts, because I think Mel did right. I think Mel did excellent. I think Mel went out her way for these women, these group of women who she knows the majority of them don't like her. She went out her way. She showed them, you know, she wanted to be comfortable. I'm going to make sure y'all comfortable, too. Y'all might not exactly like how it is, but y'all, and I don't know if I said this earlier in my video, but hell, when Letitia planned that trip to Las Vegas, Mel, Destiny, and all of them were there. This is when the Whitlows was on here, and Martell was there. Mel didn't make a stink about the accommodations. She was in a room with two twin beds. That was the kids' room of the place. Mel didn't have bougie. Mel didn't say, I can't stay here. Mel didn't say, this how you think about me. No, she put Mel in the room with Destiny. Mel didn't complain. Now, yeah, you know, Mel went the hell off because Martell was there, and she's been asking them, season after season, don't put us together. Don't put me and Martell together. Well, they put them together, and, you know, it blew up. but it had nothing to do with the arrangement. The stay arrangement. You guys, so, and I know it's going to be a lot of people who are going to be out here windmilling for Letitia and Kimmy. Y'all miss me with all that bullshit because y'all dumb as hell. Y'all dumb as hell. Because if you can tell me, any of y'all can tell me that you would sit up here and play nice with your enemy, I don't care if it is work related, you still going to be good to them? And I don't need no holy endowed person coming. Well, the Lord says, no. The Bible says, I-5-242. Y'all fight with me in the comments. Let me know your thoughts. Y'all have a good night. Bye.